Good afternoon, children. The lesson we are going to learn today is an important invention made by man, because of which our difficult tasks have become much more easier and faster. So let's understand in detail the lesson number 23, Computers. Children, you have learned the mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. You can do sums which involve any one or more of these operations. We have learned all these operations in Max. You may also solve complicated sums which involve all of these operations. You can calculate the answers quickly if you use tables. Yes, but sometimes it is necessary to carry out very complicated calculations that involve very large numbers. So if there is a sum with a very large big number, it becomes very difficult for us to calculate it. At such times, what happens? Mistakes are bound to occur in the calculations. Are bound to occur means are likely to happen. Then you waste a lot of time checking and rechecking your answers. So children, how can we avoid these errors and wastage of time? A computer is a machine that is an answer to all these problems. Computers can solve problems and carry out the most difficult calculations with amazing speed and accuracy. Amazing means astonishing, surprising. Accuracy means correctness, exactness. Computers can do several other things besides carrying out calculations. In fact, there are few things that a modern computer is not able to do. That means computer can do almost everything. Computers have memory. That is, they can store a lot of data. Data means information. They can keep words, pictures, and sounds in their memory and give you the information within a fraction of a second when you need it. Fraction of a second means very, very quickly they can give you the results. Computers can process the data or the information according to the instructions given to them. A modern computer can follow thousands of instructions within a fraction of a second. Only the instructions have to be given in a language that the computer understands. So children, we have to give the instructions in the computer language. A set of code instructions written for a computer is known as a program. Code means particular language used by a computer programmer to give a set of instructions to computer. Writing a computer program is a specialized task. Specialized means having special knowledge of a particular subject. A computer on its own does not make judgments. That is opinions about the instructions given to it. Means the computer will not give the result on its own. It follows the instructions blindly. That is why the instructions have to be written very, very carefully. The programmer has to write the instructions very carefully. And according to that instruction only, the computer will give us the result. If you miss a step, the computer will not correct it. One has to think carefully to imagine every step involved in any task. So So the programmer has to think each and every step that is involved to get the task completed. So, children, let us see if we can imagine all the steps involved in a simple task. Suppose mother has asked you to buy vegetables. You have to divide this task into smaller ones. So, children, how you will perform this task? Going to the greengrocer's shop, picking up the vegetables you want and paying for them. Coming back home. Then you have to subdivide these tasks into still smaller ones. For example, in each task, children, you have to do some more work. For example, going to the greengrocer's shop. So what you need to do before that? Take a bag for the vegetables. Take money for the vegetables. Next, start from your house. Next, walk down the street. Turn right or left. Walk down the street. Next, you will cross the street. And finally, enter greengrocer's shop. So children, you can see so many tasks you have to do to complete this one task. Each of these smaller tasks can again be divided further into even smaller tasks. Try to do that choosing any one of the above steps. But thus we see that computers are smarter than men. But children, who made them smart? Yes, it is men who do the difficult job of making them smart enough. So the next time you play a game on a computer or watch a video or obtain some information, think of the men who put in so many efforts to make it all possible. So that was all in this lesson, computers. As we have completed with this lesson, let's now begin with our written work. So children, see that you write in a very neat handwriting and complete the book on time. So open your English notebook, write today's date, the name of the lesson, lesson 23, computers. Question 1. Read the sentence and choose the correct alternative. Mistakes are bound to occur. Now there are some options given. We have to select the correct one. First, there are no mistakes. There are some mistakes. All mistakes are tied together. Answer. There are some mistakes. B. There are few things that a modern computer is not able to do. The options. A modern computer can do a few things. A modern computer cannot do a few things. A modern computer can do almost everything. So the answer is, a modern computer can do almost everything. Thank you. Question 2. List the mathematical operations in the passage. Using your mathematics textbook, write one example of each operation. Answer. The mathematical operations mentioned in the passage are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Example of each operation. First, 88,709 plus 165. So children, this is an example of addition. Second, 4000 minus 3999. Now this is an example of subtraction. Third, 598 multiplied by 51. This is an example of multiplication. Fourth, 126 divided by 9. This is an example of division. So children, just write it as it is shown in the screen. Question 3. Do you make mistakes in your calculations? What do you do to correct them? Answer. Yes, I do make mistakes sometimes. I correct them by doing the entire calculations again. Question 4. What do you do to remember the information you have gathered? Answer. I note down the information which I have gathered in my notebook. Then I read it whenever needed. Note to be completed by students. Self-study. List all the words related to computers that you find in the passage. Children, you can write this answer in your English notebook. Find and add more words to the list. Answer. Words related to computers from the passage. Program, memory. So children, I have put three blanks. You have to search for some more words from this lesson. The words should be related to computers. Write any three names. There are many words related to computer mentioned in the lesson. Any three you have to select and write and complete this answer. More words. They are also asking us to write some more words related to computer which are not mentioned in the lesson. So I have given two examples, monitor, screen, and more three you can write on your own. Remember, the words should be related to computers. You can write mouse, CPU, paint, or any other words related to computers. Children, write this answer also in your English notebook. So that was all in this lesson number 23. Computers. Thank you. Have a nice day.